planning meeting and, you know, came to the subject of who should, you know, be a part of the Star Lake Hall of Fame, right? And not a second went by before Tom's name came up. This year marks the 50th consecutive year that Tom has been here, either as a camper or on staff. That's worthy of some applause, I think. At 14 years old, Tom Scheibner was invited to Star Lake Camp as a non-salvationist. Came as a camper for 5 years, and 50 years later, here he is. Tom has expressed his connection to Star Lake and its meaning in his life quite clearly. I wouldn't be here where I am today as Assistant Territorial Music Secretary of the Salvation Army had it not been for attending Star Lake Music Camp in 1969. That experience changed the course of my life completely as I attended music camp for 5 straight years as a camper and then became a Salvation Army soldier at age 18. This enabled me to follow the Lord's leading into a career of music making and teaching. Star Lake Music Camp has become sacred grounds to me as I return to rededicate and commit myself to the Lord through the Salvation Army Music and its programs for adults and children. Wonderfully powerful words from Tom and the importance of this place that it's had on his life. I can't think of anyone that I respect more in the Salvation Army music than you, Tom. And so grateful to be able to honor you in this way tonight as you celebrate 50 years. Why don't you please greet Tom Scheibner?
Wow, I'm glad I joined with my band this morning. I almost lost it, so I hope that that, you know, takes care of it and I can get through this okay, because when I hear phrases like, oh, no one will ever break that record, you know, I think records are made to be broken. And I think there is probably a young person here tonight that could even exceed anything I've done. And I pray God that that may be so. Do it. But I didn't want to talk too much because you can find out more about me in the book. And if you'd like to look at that, that would be great. And it has a few other things in there that you may find of interest. But God bless you all. Thank you for being here tonight. Thank you for this great honor. I appreciate it.
Thank you. Hi, everyone. It is my great pleasure to welcome you to our second concert of the season, and today we have something very special in store for you. For anyone that is a fan of the New York Staff Band or Salvation Army music, you will know that earlier this year, we suddenly lost our dear friend, colleague, and longtime member of the New York Staff Band, Tom Scheibner. Shortly after Tom's passing, the whole world was flipped upside down, and we were never truly able to honor Tom as a band. While we certainly can't give Tom his full due in this manner, we hope that today our offering will honor Tom well and honor the Lord through this act of worship. What you will hear today falls into a few categories. The piece could be something that Tom wrote, perhaps a favorite of Tom's, something that we will feel will honor Tom well, or something that had been written at the request of Tom. The next two pieces fall into the last category, something that was written at the request of Tom. In 2018, he celebrated 50 straight years being at Star Lake Music Camp, either as a student, staff member, or the program director. To commemorate this anniversary, Tom requested a few friends of his, Steve Bulla and Joseph Turrin, write new music that could be played with the Appalachian Band. In just a moment, you will hear a new piece from Steve Bulla through the years, but first, we have a short piece from the pen of Joseph Turrin, Festive Prelude. We hope you enjoy. Thank you. For many years, Tom was a faithful soldier of the Montclair Citadel Corps in New Jersey, and during a good portion of his time, he was the Corps songster leader. One of the most iconic songster pieces in the repertoire and a favorite of Tom's is James Curnow's Christ's Part. Today, we will feature a brass band transcription done by NYSB alumni Philip Rayment. A few of the words: Christ he requires still, wheresoe'er he comes, to feed or lodge, to have the best of rooms. Give him the choice, grant him the nobler part. Of all the house, the best of all's the heart. The cornet solo, Just Where I Am, was arranged by Tom for the former bandmaster of the New York staff band, Derek Smith, for the band's 110th annual festival in 1997. Today, the same solo will be presented beautifully by Lieutenant John Quatela. The words of the chorus in this piece are of great importance to us as a band and as Christians. It says this, "Just where he needs me, my Lord has placed me. Just where he needs me, there would I be. And since he found me, by love he's bound me to serve him joyfully." The New York staff band was blessed to be able to take part in the memorial service for Tom, and as you can imagine, we had some very specific requests for what we should plan. One of those requests was that our principal trombone player, Mark Baker, play Ray Steadman Allen's arrangement of In the Love of Jesus. Once again, these contain absolutely beautiful words from our songbook. In the love of Jesus, there is all I need, while I follow closely where my Lord may lead. By his grace forgiven, in his presence blessed, in the love of Jesus, in the love of Jesus is perfect rest. I can still remember the day of Tom's passing like it was yesterday. Shock, disbelief, sadness, anger, and heartache were right at the forefront of my mind and heart. At 4 p.m. the previous day, I said goodbye to Tom just like any other day, and then he was just gone. Still hurts. What I can also remember on that Wednesday, a staff band rehearsal day where we gathered for prayer and music, was that I made a conscious effort and decision to hold off calling Charlene for as long as possible. Shortly after rehearsal, I got up the courage to call Charlene, honestly hoping that it would go straight to voicemail, because I wasn't sure what I would say. The good thing was that she took charge of the conversation and got to the business of Tom's funeral, the fact that she would like the band to play, and what would be involved. As you know, one of the requests was In the Love of Jesus. The other request, Tom's favorite piece of music that he'd always wanted to play at his funeral, Eric Ball's Resurgam. It was at that moment that I officially regret not calling Charlene earlier in the day before our rehearsal. We were just asked to play perhaps the most famous of Salvation Army band pieces for our most beloved member without a rehearsal. If only I called earlier. Well, we were going to honor Tom and play Resurgam, and now we would do it with a few minutes of rehearsal. No pressure. It went well enough on the day, but it's wonderful to have another chance at playing this great music for this great man. Eric Ball's piece, Resurgam, is arguably the most popular and meaningful piece of music in all of the Salvation Army banding literature. The title of the piece, Resurgam, can be translated, I Shall Rise Again, and tosses around the idea of contrast and conflict into high relief. Rather than go on about the piece, here is the program note provided by the composer, Eric Ball. The opening theme is a setting of the passage from the Apocrypha. The souls of the righteous are in the hand of God, and no torment shall touch them. In the eyes of the foolish, they seem to have died. Their departure was accounted to be their hurt, and their journeying away from us to be their ruin. But they are in peace. This faith motif recurs a number of times during the work, and in contrast, there occurs music charged with high emotion, sometimes harsh and discordant, in moods despairing, sorrowful, and fearful. Finally, the music achieves serenity and closes with a very quiet statement of the opening tune. The tone poem is not based upon any specific program. Resurgam, I Shall Rise Again, will evoke differing moods and images in the mind of each individual, performer, and listener, some personal, some universal. This is Eric Ball's Resurgam.
Thank you. Thank you.
For anyone that has ever been to Starlake Music Camp, you have undoubtedly seen Tom Scheibner lead the Starlake Benediction at the end of the program. For this special event, Dorothy Gates has taken the music of Dick Krommenhoek and created this special arrangement. These words will have great meaning to any Starlaker and will undoubtedly bring up memories of Tom leading all the campers and staff as we close out our program. O Father, let thy love remain. O Son, may I thy likeness gain. O Spirit, stay to comfort me. O Triune God, praise be to thee.
Thank you.
To close out our concert today, we are featuring another new item composed in memory of Tom. This time, we have a new piece from good friend and NYSB alumni, Peter Graham. This quick march will have a few recognizable tunes, including the Starlight Pep song. If you are so inspired, feel free to stand on your chair. You will also notice that we have had a bit of a uniform change for this one, our official Scheibes t-shirt. This march is simply called Hail SLC and is our last tribute to our great friend, Tom Scheibner. We pray that you have been blessed and encouraged today and hope this time has helped flood your mind with great memories. Thanks for stopping by. Thank you.